Good evening, students. See, today we are going to do rational number from the chapter previous year important questions. Few students have coming end of June this chapter 1 rational number test in their school. So it will be a revision for them. At the same time, whatever the questions asked in the previous years in the school test, in the annual exam, no, all that from this chapter we will revise today. So first we learn the important points to remember from this chapter. So rational number. So what is a rational number? First point is any number in the form P by Q, where Q is not equal to 0 and P, Q are integers, is called rational numbers. So what is rational number? Any number P by Q form, well, the denominator should not be equal to 0, because if denominator becomes 0, you cannot, this has become an indefinite value. So Q is not equal to 0, not defined if it becomes 0. Some P and Q are integers, is called rational number. And then this rational number has few properties. That is, it is closed under rational numbers are closed under addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, where denominator is not equal to 0. What do you mean by closed means? When you add two rational number, the solution also rational number. That is 1 by 2 plus 5 by 6. When you add, take LCM 6, so it will become 3 plus 5, 8 by 6. So when we add, the solution also rational number. Adding rational number, solution also rational number means it is closed under addition. Similarly, when you subtract the rational number, the solution also will be the rational number. So multiplication, when you multiply two rational number, you get a solution also rational number. So what we mean by closed? When we do addition, the solution also rational number. When you do subtraction of rational number, solution also rational number. When you multiply the rational number, the solution also the rational number. When you divide two rational number, the solution also a rational number, provided denominator should not be equal to 0. Okay. So now, it is closed under addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Then, properties of addition. Now, we learned in the previous statement, it is closed under addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Now, under each one, addition, what are the properties we will see. That is, if you have two rational number, when you add, you know it is going to be a rational number. That is why we have said closed. It is also, when you change the position, this is called closure property. That is what in general, if any two rational number, when we add, it is also a rational number, and when you change its position, you will get the same rational number. A by B plus C by D is equal to C by D plus A plus B. So these two rational numbers can be, under the closure property, we call it as commutative property. Okay, so it a commutative property is closed, we will say. Then second part, we also call it as when you have three numbers, A by B plus C by D plus E by F. If I take the bracket from the first and then here if I change its position, we call this as associative property. Associative property. That is, while adding three or more rational number, we can group it in any order. Okay, so while adding 3 or more rational number. While adding 3 or more rational number, they can be grouped in any order. The answer will be the same. See here, A by B plus C by D plus E by F. We are adding 3 rational number. First, we group the first 2 rational and added with the third one. Then in the second RHS part, we group the last 2 and added with the first. But anyhow, the solution is going to be the same. So, while adding 3 or more rational number, they can be grouped in any order. We call it as associative property. Then we have one more property. We call it as identity element. Identity element. What do you mean by identity element? Suppose if you have a fraction, if I add 0, what you get? We get the same rational number. Is it not? So, either you add 0 to the rational number or the rational number is added to the 0, we get the same element. So, this we call it as identity element. So, if you put it in a simple word, I can say the sum of any rational number, the sum of any rational number and 0 is rational number itself. Okay, so when you add 0, it is the same number. So, 0 is called, so this is what? 0 is called identity element. Okay, identity number for addition. Because when we add 0 to the rational number or 0 is added to any rational number, we get the same rational number. So, what you are adding, you get the same number by adding 0. So, 0 is called identity element. Next, negative of rational number. What do you mean by negative of rational number? Suppose if I have a rational number A by B, its negative is what? Minus A by B, is it not? If I have minus A by B, it's negative. Negative means what? Minus of minus A by B, which will become plus A by B. So, A by B, its negative is minus A by B. Minus A by B negative is A by B. So, now what happens? No, when you add both A by B and its negative, we get 0. So, we call this as additive inverse. So, what do you call? It's called additive inverse. That is, when you add for any rational number, if you add its additive inverse, you should get the solution to be 0. That is called additive inverse. So, are you able to understand the difference between identity? Identity is the 0 is added, you get the same question. Identity, same way. But negative is when you add with the opposite sign, you will get 0. We call it as additive inverse. Don't get confused with identity element and additive inverse. Okay. So, additive inverse is a rational number and its opposite sign when we add, we will get 0. So, what you are getting, when you are getting 0, when you add with opposite number, that opposite rational number, we call it as additive inverse. Now, next we learn properties of multiplication. So, now we are, first we completed with addition. So, now we are going to do properties of multiplication for rational numbers. So, here also, first one, you know the closure property, no? What do you mean by closure property? When we multiply the two rational number, the solution is also rational number. A by B into C by D. So, when you replace the position C by D into A by B also, it is going to be the same. So, we say associative property. What do you call this one? We call it as this commutative property is closure. So, for any two rational number can be multiplied in order, it is called commutative property, closure. Commutative property of multiplication. That is, commutative property is closed under multiplication. What you mean by closure property? When we multiply any two rational number, the solution also rational number. So it is closed. So when you are multiplying and you change the order, it is going to be same. It is commutative property. So we say commutative property is closed under multiplication. Same way, associative property. What we mean by associative property? A by B, C by D into E by F. When you multiply under multiplication, 3, and when you changes its position, the bracket of multiplication, if you change it, it will not, answer is same. You are going to get the same rational number. That means I can put it like this as a statement. For the product of 3 or more rational number, they can be grouped in any order, is it not? Here see, first I grouped A, B, first two rational number and multiplied with third one. In RHS, I grouped last two and multiplied with the first one. So the product of 3 or more rational number, they can be grouped in any order. This is associative property. Okay, and associative property is also closed, because when you multiply, you get a rational number. Here also, if you change the order, you get the rational number. So the rational number multiplied in any order, the answer is going to get rational number. So we say associative property is closed under multiplication. Next, property, we will say multiplicative identity. So, how you did in your additive identity? You have identity means you should get the same question, no? So, in multiplicative, when you get the same question, when you multiplied by 1. Suppose if you have a rational number multiplied by 1, you get the same. Or 1 multiplied by this rational number, you get the same rational number. So, we say 1 is called multiplicative identity. Okay, 1 is called multiplicative identity. Same way, where what you multiply, you get 0. So we call property of 0. A by B into 0 is same as 0 into A by B. Is it not? All are equal to 0. So it is called property of 0 for multiplication. Property of 0 for multiplication. Okay. So, 1 is called multiplicative identity. When what multiplied by 0, you get it as 0. You call property of 0 under multiplication. Now, reciprocal of rational number. Reciprocal of a rational number. If I have a rational number A by B, what is its reciprocal? B by A. What do you mean by reciprocal? We change the position of numerator and denominator. Numerator becomes denominator, denominator becomes numerator. So that we call it as reciprocal. So reciprocal of A by B is equal to B by A. Now what happens when a number is multiplied by its reciprocal? You get cancelled everything and you get 1. So, we call this reciprocal of rational number as multiplicative inverse. So, we call reciprocal of rational number is called multiplicative inverse. Okay, so you know a word, a reciprocal. Now we have come for higher class. Our vocabulary, the words also should be on the higher level. So reciprocal of rational number, we call it as multiplicative inverse. Okay, so in this, when you see any number 5 by 3, reciprocal is 3 by 5. If I have only 4, I can write 4 as a rational number, 4 by 1, and I can write the reciprocal as 1 by 4. Okay. So, any number, you can make it as multiplicative inverse. Even if it is a natural number or whole number, you can put the denominator 1 and make it as a fraction, and then you can do the rational number. But only thing we can't do that one is for 0. 0 has no reciprocal. Why? 0. How can you write 0 as fraction? 0 by 1. It's reciprocal. What is its reciprocal? 1 by 0. But we know anything with denominator 0 not defined. Is it not? So we say 0 has no reciprocal. This will be coming for your MCQs or true or false. Okay. 0 has no reciprocal. Justify, they will tell. So you should write no 0. 0 can be written as rational number 0 by 1. Its reciprocal is 1 by 0. But you know, anything with denominator 0 is not defined. That is why we say 0 doesn't have any reciprocal. Okay. So now we have done an important points of the rational number properties under addition and multiplication. Now we will go few sums based on your annual exams or the chapters question, whatever asked in the different schools like Air Force School, Delhi Public School, KV, all the schools. The maximum possibility of questions from this chapter, we will revise now. First question, verify the following. Okay. So in this revision class, mostly we are going to do the difficult subtopic, what you find it very, what you call, lot of careless mistake you may do. So those things to overcome in exam time. Such a difficult sum, we will class do it here now in revision so that you can practice more and to get full good marks in your exam. Verify the following. First question is minus 8 by 15 plus 4 by 5 is equal to 4 by 5 plus minus 8 by 15. We have to verify, okay? You know, by our rational number, this is closed under what associative or distributive you should think about, and it is closed under commutative, is it not? So, I have to take, this is LHS part. After the equal sign, what we have? RHS part. We simplify LHS. First, we simplify LHS, get one solution. And we simplify RHS, we get one solution. And we check both the solutions are same. Okay. So, now, what is our LHS? Minus 8 by 15. Plus 4 by 5. So we take LCM of denominator. What is LCM of 15 and 5? We have 15. This 15 will go in this LCM 15 one time. So we have minus 8 into 1 minus 8. 5 will go in 15 three times. So I multiply the numerator. 4 threes are 12. Now minus 8 plus 12. How much? 12 minus 8. 4 by 15. I simplify and I got it as 4 by 15. Now we take RHS. What is our RHS? 4 by 5 plus of minus 8 by 15. Here also LCM for the denominator 5 and 15. What it is? 15. So when I take LCM 15, 5 will go in this 15 three times. So that 3 I should multiply in numerator. 4 threes are 12. This 15 will go in this LCM 15 one time. So 15 ones are 15. So I get minus 8 ones are 8. Which is 12 minus 8. 4 by 15. Now you see, when we simplified LHS, we got 4 by 15. When we simplified RHS, we got 4 by 15. That means what? Therefore, LHS is equal to RHS. Both have same answer. What is LHS? Minus 8 by 15 plus 4 by 15. 5, that given question. Plus 4 by 5 plus of minus 8 by 15. They are equal. We have proved. Okay. So, this is with addition we have proved it. Now, you have second sum with multiplication. Okay. If I take this as A sum and this as B sum. minus 3 by 7 into 5 by 8 is equal to 5 by 8 into minus 3 by 7. Okay, first you should understand the difference between the first sum and the second sum. First sum we did under addition, we have proved it is equal. Now second sum under multiplication. So we take LHS. Minus 3 by 7 into 5 by 8. So for multiplication, what we will do? You multiply the numerator and multiply the denominator. Multiply the numerator, minus 3 into 5. Minus 15, 3 5s are 15, divided by 7, 8. 7 into 8, how much? 7 8s are 56. So we got in LHS multiplication, minus 15 by 56. Now we try for RHS. RHS is 5 by 8 into minus 3 by 7. Multiply the numerator, 5 3s are 15, with minus 3, so minus 15. 8 7s are 56. Now, you got LHS minus 15 by 56. RHS also minus 15 by 56. That means both the solutions are same. Therefore, LHS is equal to RHS. Okay, you can finish it here. Or you can write, what is LHS? Minus 3 by 7 into 5 by 8 is equal to 5 by 8 into minus 3 by 7, we have proved. So whether it is addition or multiplication, if they ask you, verify the following. Take LHS, simplify. Take RHS and simplify. And check both the answers are same. Normally only when the rational numbers are interchanged disposition, the answer will be the same. Because it is commutative property, it is closed. So we find in such a way LHS equal to RHS. And we verify the given rational numbers with addition and multiplication equal symbol, and we show the proof and write LHS is equal to RHS. Now we do question number 3. Now in question number 3, it is like this. What should be added to 3 by 4 so that sum may be, that is when you add, the answer should be 0. So what you know, when you can do get 0, when we subtract, when you negative number of this, when you take, what do you mean by negative of that number? So we say it as additive inverse. So 3 by 4 plus of minus 3 by 4 is 0. So what should be added to get 0? So we add negative of 3 by 4. Negative of 3 by 4. That is minus 3 by 4 should be added to get the sum 0. Okay. So what should be added to get 0 means whatever number they have given with the opposite sign you should add. Here plus 3 by 4 is given. So the opposite sign is minus 3 by 4 is added to get 0. In this way you should write. Next question number 4. Verify x plus y is equal to y plus z. Y plus x for x is equal to 5 by 6, y is equal to 3 by 4. You have to verify x plus y is equal to y plus x. And they have given x is 5 by 6, y is 3 by 4. Okay. So what is LHS part? X plus y. X plus y means 5 by 6 plus 3 by 4. Okay. Then LCM of 6 and 4 what? Is it not 12? So we write 12 as LCM. 6 will go in 12 2 times. That 2 I will multiply in the numerator. 5 2s are 10. 4 will go in LCM 12 3 times. That 3 I should multiply with the numerator. 3 3s are 9. So this will become 19 by 12. So LHS x plus y is 19 by 12 we got by substituting the x and y given value. Now we take RHS. RHS is what? Y plus x. What is y plus x? 3 by 4 plus 5 by 6. Y is 3 by 4, x is 5 by 6. Now, take LCM of 4 and 6. For 4 and 6 also it is 12. So, when you take LCM 12, 4 will go in 12 3 times. So, we should multiply 3 with the numerator. 3 3s are 9. 6 will go in LCM 12 2 times. So, multiply with numerator. 5 2s are 10. 9 plus 10, 19 by 12. So, you can see here LHS x plus y is 19 by 12. RHS y plus x is 19 by 12. Therefore, x plus y is equal to y plus x. We have proved it. So, like this, when they give with the variable and the values of the variable, you should substitute and do in your regular rational number simplification and show finding LCM, LHS is equal to RHS, and we have to prove it. Now, question number 5. If 8 by 17 plus 4 by 5 is equal to 4 by 5 plus x, find x. See, you know, addition is closed, is it not? 8 by 17 plus 4 by 5 is equal to 4 by 5 plus x. So, we know by your one of the properties of this, addition is closed under commutative property or associative property, is it not? So, we will write. This is two numbers, two fractions we are adding, two rational number. So, we are writing by commutative property of addition in rational number x is equal to, see, 4 by 5, 4 by 5 is there. What is left of? 8 by 17. This is the solution. So, not necessary here. You have to find the value and all. They have asked if 8 by 17 plus 4 by 5 is equal to 4 by 5 plus x. They have given they are equal. If it is equal, find x. So, how will you find x? By the commutative property of addition in rational number. X is equal to 8 by 17. Okay. Next. For question number 6, find the sum of rational numbers minus 5 by 16 and 7 by 12. Okay? So, that is what you have to find. Minus 5 by 16 plus 7 by 12, how much you should find. So, you find first LCM of 16 and 12. So, how will you find LCM? Bigger number, if you find difficult, you do like this method. 2 will go in 16, 2 8s are, 2 6s are. Again, 2 will go, 2 4s are, 2 3s are. Then, 2 2s are, 2 3, 2 1, 3, 3 1, 1. When you multiply, 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16, 16 3s are 48. So, LCM of 16 and 12 is 48. So, here when I take LCM 48, 16 will go in 48 how many times? 16 ones are 16, 16 twos are 32, 16 threes are 48. So, that 3 I should multiply with numerator. 5 threes are minus 15, minus 5 into 3. This 3 how it came? 16 will go in 48, LCM 3 times. So, minus 5 threes are 15 plus 12 will go in 48 4 times. 12 ones are 12, 12 twos are 24, 12 threes are 36, 12 fours are 48. 4 times it will go. That 4 I should multiply with numerator. 7 fours are 28. So, when you have minus 15 plus 28, 1 plus 1 minus, we subtract 8 minus 5, 3, 2 minus 1, 13 and put bigger number sign. Here bigger number is 28, so positive sign 13 by 48. So, this is the solution. So, you should write, therefore, minus 5 by 16 plus 7 by 12 is equal to 13 by 48. You have found the sum of two rational number by finding the LCM as 13 by 48. Now, if for a 4-mark question, they'll ask you verify the following. They'll give x into y plus z is equal to x into y plus y into z for x is equal to 3 by 5, y is equal to minus 2 by 5, z is equal to minus 7 by 5. Okay, they have given x into y plus z is x into y plus y into z, and you got each value, variable value, x, y, z. Okay, you should be careful. It looks very simple for you, but because of minus sign, you should be very careful. Substitute each in LHS, find one solution, RHS, find a solution, and you have to show LHS equal to RHS. Here the question is given, verify. Verify means what? It should be equal. If you didn't get equal, you should know you have gone somewhere wrong and you have to recheck your answer and get it corrected. Okay? So now we take LHS. LHS is what? X into Y plus Z. So first we do, what is inside the bracket? Y plus Z. What is Y plus Z? Minus 2 by 5 plus of minus 7 by 5. Whatever they have given that value, we will substitute. Now, you can see the denominator is same. So, I write the denominator and whatever I have in the numerator, minus 2 plus minus minus 7. So, we get minus 9 by 5. Y plus Z is minus 2 by 5 plus of minus 7 by 5. We are substituting the given value and simplifying that Y plus Z and got it as minus 9 by 5. Therefore, X into Y plus Z. What is X? 3 by 5 multiplied by Y plus Z we got now? Minus 9 by 5. So, when we have multiplication, you just multiply the numerator and multiply the denominator. 3 into minus 9, minus 27. 9 threes are 27. 5 fives are 25. That is our LHS value. Okay. X into Y plus Z is minus 27 by 25 we got. Next we take RHS. In RHS what you have to do? X into Y plus Y into Z. So we take first X into Y. What is X? 3 by 5 multiplied by Y is minus 2 by 5. This will become 3 into minus 2 minus 6. 5 5s are 25. Next, we have to find X into Y into X into Z. X into Z. What is X now? 3 by 5 into minus 7 by 5. So, minus 21 by 25. Now, our RHS is what? Therefore, X into Y plus X into Z. X into Y plus X into Z. X into Y what? Minus 6 by 25. X into Z you got it as minus 21 by 25. So when we add, what we should get? LCM is same, no? 25. So we should add the numerator. Minus 6 plus of minus minus 21. Minus 27 by 25. So you can see here, when you take LHS simplification minus 27 by 25, RHS simplification also minus 27 by 25. Therefore, LHS is equal to RHS. Thus verified. What you verified? X into Y plus Z is equal to X into Y plus X into Z we have verified. Actually, no, they have given you the question X into Y plus Z is X into Y plus X into Z. And they have given you the values. Take LHS, substitute and simplify. It's a simple fraction calculation. But you should be careful with the minus sign and do calculation correctly. And always whenever they give verify, it should be equal. If you are not getting LHS equal to RHS, somewhere in your calculation you would have gone wrong. Please check and rectify. Verification means always what the statement they have given will be the right one. You have to just prove it, LHS equal to RHS.